Good evening, and welcome to tonight's performance at Calvin University. Welcome to those of you who made it through the COVID screening gauntlet to get in here in person. Welcome to all of you who are joining remotely. My name is Jamie Skillen. I teach environmental studies, and I also direct Calvin's Ecosystem Preserve and Native Gardens. So yes, on most Friday evenings this time of year, I'm actually listening to concerts performed by chorus frogs, wood frogs, barred owls. But I broke from routine this evening because I have the honor of introducing Rhonda Sider Edgington. Introducing her and hearing her performance pieces by Margaret Sandresky. Rhonda has taught organ at Calvin since 2019. She's also performed here before. Once as part of the American Guild of Organists Bach Cantata concert with orchestra director John Verano, and as featured soloist during the percussion ensemble's performance of Lou Harrison's Concerto for Organ and Percussion, both in 2015. I'll add, I've known Rhonda for almost 30 years, and it is a true privilege to work with her here at Calvin. She's not only a gifted organist, she's also a remarkable teacher and mentor to her students. I would refer you to the program. You can read a little bit more about Rhonda's biography, read some of the experience and credentials internationally as a Fulbright scholar in Germany, and read about some of the interesting places that she's performed. In Grand Rapids, though, if you are local, you maybe heard her at Fountain Street Church, St. Adalbert's Basilica, Mayflower Congregational, Trinity Lutheran, First United Methodist, and Westminster Presbyterian Church. She also enjoys playing the carillon and can occasionally be heard regaling traffic at GVSU's downtown clock and bell tower over the lunch hour. So thank you for joining us and welcome again. Before Rhonda begins, please pause for a moment and I'll open with prayer. God of grace and mercy, beauty and creativity, thank you that you have filled your creation with music, some performed by us, and other music performed by many of your other creatures. It has been a long and difficult year under the shadow of COVID-19, and that only deepens our gratitude for the gift of music. Through it, we hear sorrow and joy. We hear our thoughts expressed in ways that words cannot. Thank you for Rhonda, for her skill and dedication, and for her generosity in sharing both with us this evening. Amen. So if you join me in welcoming Rhonda. Thank you.
Well, thank you for being here, those of you who are here in person and those who are watching over the live stream. I've done a number of live streams in the last year, and this is the first one where I've been able to have an audience in person as well, which is more exciting. So thank you all for being here. And this concert is celebrating the works of an American composer, Margaret Sandresky. I've been playing Sandresky's works for about 10 years now, and while she's certainly known in some organist circles, I feel like her works aren't as well known as they could or should be, and I especially want to celebrate the fact that she is turning 100 years old this month. And I think her musical voice is unique, it's original, and it's unexpected, but usually quite accessible to the listener as well. So I have a wide variety of her works on the program. The next piece is one of the earliest pieces by her that I play. It's perhaps the most challenging of the certain movements that are rather dissonant, but if this doesn't strike your fancy, hang on, because pieces coming up later will be a little less dissonant. This piece is a setting of a very well-known Renaissance folk tune, L'Homme Arme, and this folk tune actually refers to the armed man, like a suit of armor, so some kind of soldier. It's a really secular text for the tune, so it's a little unclear why it was used so often for mass settings, but Sandresky is hearkening back to this tradition, starting in the Renaissance, of using this tune as the basis for mass settings. So I'm gonna play the little melody before I begin the first piece, so you'll have that melody in your ear, since it's not a tune that we often know. And then we'll hear the Mass by Sandresky L'Homme Arme.
Thank you.
I just love how that cycle ends. I think that Agnus Dei is so ethereal and peaceful. It's just a gorgeous ending to that piece. So next we're going to have a setting of Amazing Grace. I have played this many places and I always hear comments from people. I think it's really fun to have a tune that we all know so well, that's so familiar, and then have somebody set it in a new way with different harmonies, with unexpected little twists. So this is a gorgeous piece, and I'll move from that straight into the Five Sacred Dances, which is one of Sandreski's most programmatic pieces. I think it's really fun because she does a lot of tone painting and painting with music of these pictures that we have. There's a lot of really programmatic elements of the piece. And one thing that you can be listening for in the final movement, David danced before the Ark of the Lord. I talk in my program notes a little bit about how this is an ecstatic dance. We can hear it beginning with the sound of the shofar, kind of echoing back and forth. But I always found the B section, the middle section, a little bit enigmatic. There's this repeated note, and I can't quite understand. I mean, I think it's effective, it's fun to play, but I sometimes wonder, well, what exactly is she going for here? So if you have any ideas how this fits in with the David dancing for the Ark of the Lord, I would love to hear it. And I'll take this chance to say also, if you're watching online, there's a link that you can click for the program, and included in the program is also program notes I've written about the pieces. So if you're wanting to read along as you listen, you're welcome to do that. So we'll have Amazing Grace and then straight into the Five Sacred Dances.
Thank you.
that's an exciting piece. That's usually the end of the program. So now I have to keep on playing today, though. I love that last movement. It's so exciting. Hopefully for you as well as for me. So the next piece is the only one in my program today that is not based on a hymn or a sacred theme, but I thought I'd include it both because it's a really fun piece with a lot of wonderful melodies, and just to give you a sense of that Sandrosi doesn't write only sacred and church works. As I said in my notes, this was written for as kind of a 30th birthday present for another American composer, Carson Kuman, and shows off a lot of lovely colors of the organ. And I'll follow that immediately with the her setting of A Mighty Fortress. And as I was writing my program notes, I realized that when she was in college, Sandrosky was a TA for, I think it was 18th century counterpoint class. So I figured that's part of the reason that she wrote such a lovely prelude in the old style on A Mighty Fortress. She knows a lot about counterpoint, right? So we'll do the next two pieces.
Thank you.
Thank you. Before I play my last piece, just wanted to thank all the folks at Calvin here who made this possible, from the programs and the sound and the live stream and everything. It's been great to be teaching here the last couple years and working with students, and fun to play a performance here on campus, even though it's, you know, it is what it is right now. But I trust that there are some of you out there watching besides my parents, and thanks to those of you who are here in person too. So this is the last piece on the program, and I hope if you've enjoyed these pieces that you go look up some Margaret Sandresky at home if you're an organist, and if you're a listener, that you're always open to hearing pieces that you don't know, because there's always all kinds of treasures and surprises out there that that we don't know that will make our lives happy, right? Okay, thank you for watching.